No.
It's okay.
No, it's not okay.
Part of the gig. Phenom. Harlan, what are you doing?
What am I doing? I am done stripping with a stripper on this door, so I'm getting all the freaking old timer out of the way with a red Scotch Brite and some lacquer thinner. Come back and wipe it off while it's still wet. That shows the bare metal underneath. This is what we're trying to get to all the way around. This car had like four layers of paint on it, more than that. Here we'll find a little bit of the original color, but that was underneath Bondo and primer and black and a lot of stuff, just to get to that.
So all we're doing right now is an acid cleaning bath. So we take a rag, we soak it in acid, we wipe down the fender, we take our little wire brush, we scrub out all our rust holes, we try to get it all perfectly clean, then we rinse it with water and we dry it with a dry paper towel, and then we take a blow gun and we blow straight on it, we dry it all the way off. If you don't dry it off, it etches into the metal.
Right here, it's a little flat doll kind of looking silver. This is lead. This, I jigged all these holes up all through here, and I dollied all the metal and got all the dent out real nice. I got a crease line right in here a little bit where it's between body line and a little one down here, and a little bit right in that corner, and I'm gonna blend lead all the way here. I got a little tiny one right there, I'm gonna blend some lead there. And then I'm gonna go up here. This is where it had a rip and a bunch of holes in it. I tigged all that and fixed that. And then down here, it just had a bunch of holes. I'm gonna lead all this area where this old joint is right here. I'm clean this out after I'm done the door and do this. So that's about it. Tigged up a bunch of stuff in the back, but I'm gonna move to that probably tomorrow or late this afternoon. So. Alright, I'm getting ready to live. Well, I'm just cutting this little spot away for some access, and I'm fitting my piece on and off real quick, but it's got such a damaged area, I want to get some of the crap out of the way, it won't drip in the hydraulic fluid. In my mouth. Okay, let's get this off. And then I can open it up and I can straighten out this inner structure that got bent. And then I can weld in a new piece after a lot of cleaning and cutting that. Let's get this off. That gives you a little idea. I got something to pick at it with. I have to get get up in there and get all this out. I don't know what that is. Old insulation. Ugh. It's just old insulation. I just joked with squirrel hair. Squirrel hair, but it's supposed to be some insulation. Anyway, this is all the bent area. Previous old damage. I'm gonna make a new piece. Well, I've already made it. Now this just kind of came off of the wall, really. That's all there. Just old damage, you know. So that inner structure right there, I'm gonna clean that up. I'll straighten that out, and that'll give me access to be able to. Yeah, it gives you an idea. This is sticking back in place real quick. I'm gonna just move that back in. And that takes care of this little area. All that I'll straighten back out. So. Alright. I've just been wheeling the edge down. I got the bottom down real good. I gotta run across it on the upper. On that top edge so I get it really even with all the see what makes that top line really nice. It's all the little things out of there. Up, tacked in place, just set where I'm going to get ready to start tape welding her. That's all. Come back when I'm getting her done. Thank you.
Oh, it's a long thing.